Hello guys, and welcome back to the class. And now we're going to talk about Arduino and working with Arduino. Of course, we need to work with Arduino hands-on. Difficult for us to do that unless you already have a set of Arduinos at home, but there is an alternative and we will talk about that later. So for this video, which is part one of Arduino, I'm going to talk about the theory of Arduino, or things that you need to learn before we talk about Arduino. Now, of course, one of the things you needed to learn was the programming, and that's why we did refresher on C++. See, the Arduino programming language is based on C or C++, so by refreshing on C++, you're ready to work with Arduino language. Of course, there is more to it, but we will deal with that later. So what are we going to talk about? We're going to talk about the Arduino board itself, the types of Arduinos, hardware setup and safety precautions, the IDE, and then working with Arduinos up until here. Then the tutorials and exercises that we will be in the next video. So let's talk about Arduino. So what is an Arduino? Is obviously, we talked about that in a class before, but let's do that again. Essentially, it's an open source electronics platform. Essentially, it's a controller and chip, easy to use hardware components and software. The Arduino board can read input from push buttons, sensors, and switches, and then it can produce outputs to LEDs, motors, actuators, etc. And the boards are programmed by uploading a set of instructions, sketches. Now, we call it a program, but in Arduino language, oops, what happened here? In Arduino program, it's called a sketch. We will get to that later. Now, these sketches or instructions or programs are written in Arduino programming language, which is essentially a library built upon C++. What does that mean? Basically, it means that somebody came and wrote a set of library or functions and saved those functions in a library called Arduino. And that Arduino, when they created those functions, they wrote that in C++. And this library is called Arduino. Something similar, like, for example, Android. Android is built upon Java, so same concept. The Arduino IDE is an IDE that is specifically meant for Arduino. We already work with Genie, but obviously when we work with Arduino directly, we will be working with the Arduino IDE. Now, of course, you will be working with Arduino IDE if you are working with a physical Arduino. But if you're working with simulations or stuff like that, then maybe you're not going to be able to use this, but instead you will use another IDE. Okay, so advantages, I'll leave this part for you to figure out, which is inexpensive, cross-platform, simple and easy to program, and everything is open source, etc., etc. Next, different types of Arduinos. We are working with this Arduino, which is Arduino Uno, which is, has the biggest features, but for some people or for some functions, we don't necessarily need all of this. So there is a simplified version of this. So this is Nano, which is the smallest one. This is Mega, which is even bigger than this one. And this is NodeMCU. NodeMCU is an Arduino plus networking capabilities. So essentially solves the one of the issues with Arduino that is not network ready. Okay, what's next? Well, let's get familiar with the Arduino board. Now, I strongly suggest that you take this picture somewhere, print it out in color, and save it or have it ready on your board, or at least somewhere on your computer, so have it ready at hand when you need it. Now, luckily for us, in this Arduino board, that the board itself is numbered, as you can see here. So we have the numbers right there, and then you can see 13, 13, 12, 12, and so on and so forth. Unfortunately, this luxury we don't have in the Raspberry Pi later on. So maybe for the Arduino it's easier because the numbers are on the boards directly. But for later on when we work with the Raspberry Pi, then you will have to start counting pins because they are not numbered. You'll have to figure out the numbers by counting. Now, what else is going on here? Of course, this is the controller, a bunch of family members, reset button in case you did a lot of things that you cannot fix anymore, USB ports, power source, and the maps. Now notice that these guys over here are numbered A1, A0, A1, A2, A3, A5, because these are analog pins. They are meant for analog sensors. whereas the rest here are all digital pins, meaning they can work with digital sensor. This is one of the advantages of the Arduino board, that it works with analog as well as digital sensors. Other than that, we have power buttons, we have grounds, and we have also a bunch of other things like special pins. 6 and 5 are VP for actuators, again here for actuators, and a bunch of special sensors and special devices here. Okay, what's next? Now, this is very, very important. This part right here is very important to understand, in the sense that, you see, the Arduino itself, let me just hide this guy. Yeah. Okay. See, working with the Arduino, or any controller for that matter, involves three general areas. First of all, you have the hardware issues. And that means, yeah, all the wiring connected properly, you put all the wirings in the correct pin numbers, all the sensors, all the actuators, all the components are properly wired and connected. You're using the breadboard correctly. You have all the safety precautions done here and making sure that all of that is done and well and ready. Then the next thing you have to ensure is interaction, meaning you've done all of that, okay, great, but you have to remember that you need to have instructions sent from the PC to the Arduino. So for that to happen, some form of connection between these two has to be there. So let's just insert a nice arrow here. So this guy right here has to be able to talk to each other. Otherwise, this won't work. So let's make that a little bit thicker. Yeah. So you will have to be able to connect between the PC or the laptop and your Arduino to send instructions. Once this interaction has been set up and it's working and we are able to talk to each other, then we come to the final challenge, which is programming. You see, it's very important that you understand that if you are having problems with the Arduino, if you basically your system is not doing the task, you need to ask yourself, where is the source of the problem? See, okay, I built up my system, I connected it, I programmed it, I run it, it's not working. So what is the problem? And this is very challenging for beginners, because then we need to find out, where is the problem coming from? Is it the hardware? Is it interaction? Or is it programming? That's why I would suggest that when you do troubleshooting, that you'll have to follow the correct sequence, which is from left to right. That means you first start by double checking the hardware. Did you connect everything correctly? Did you put all the wiring correctly? Did you match the circuit given to you? Did you connect to the correct pins? Did you use the correct layout? Did you do everything correctly? Once you're sure that you're clear about everything here, then you can move on to the next issue. Is your Arduino really connected to the PC or not? Because sometimes if you unplug the USB and maybe you forget to put it in another port or something like that, and then you lose the connection. You will need to then re-establish it. So you have to make sure that essentially it's all working there. Once you're sure or 100% that this is also done, then only then you need to go and troubleshoot your program, making sure that the program is written correctly, error-free, and so on. Now, when we worked with Genie, and when we were writing C++ programs, and then when you get a program error, you might then think, oh, that's a software issue, and therefore we're going to have a problem in the program. However, when you work with Arduino and working with the Arduino IDE, and you get an error, the error could be one of these three things. It could be a hardware issue. Maybe the sensor is not started properly. It could be a network issue, an interaction issue. The error might say, I don't know what board are you talking about. I'm unable to send this instruction to because I'm not connected to anything. Or it could be a programming issue. So, you see, in the past, when you're working with C++ or Python and you get an error problem, usually it's a software issue. But now, when you're getting errors on Python or errors on Arduino IDE, the errors could be one of these three areas. Could be a hardware problem, could be interaction problem, or could be a program problem or a software problem. That is why you should always start with the hardware, troubleshoot it first, then the interaction, making sure that these two are talking to each other, and then finally make sure that the program is written correctly with no errors there. I just want to copy that arrow here and put it here as well, just to be consistent. Okay, what's next? Well, okay. This would have been very powerful if we are in a lab right now, but we're not. So anyway, it's possible that you already have your own Arduino at home and you would like to work with it, no problem. In this case, the Arduino, then you need to pay attention to this following instruction because it's very, very important that you follow them. Otherwise, you could risk damaging the board itself. So the Arduino can only supply 40 milliampere in output. So if let's say you bought a motor and it's required more than 40 milliampere, it will not work. If you force it to do so, it won't work and it might damage the board. So the maximum limit for the total amperage output of the board is essentially 40 milliampere. The next point is here, which is connecting the LED directly to the output pin. Essentially, we call this shorting. If you short circuit the board, if you take the output, say an LED, and you put it directly to the board without a resistor, if let's say you take an LED and you put it directly to the output without a resistor, it will actually provide, there'll be a lot of power coming into the LED, it might damage it. Second of all, here, if you put an output pin to the ground directly, will actually cause a short circuit, and this could damage the Arduino almost instantly. Now, we provided in this training or in this course detailed diagrams of the circuit you need to follow. So make sure you follow these instructions. Now, if you have to make sure that the Arduino board is not on a metallic surface, but this one is usually solved easily because we put it in a case. And finally, if you apply more than a voltage, more than the rated operating voltage to the pin, could damage the sensors or the wireless network module. What does that mean? See, if you go back here and you notice that somewhere here it says 5 volt to this pin right here. If you provide it with 6 volt, for example, it could damage the device. Same thing here. This one can accept a maximum 3.3 volt, but if you provide it with more, then it will be actually a problem, and so on and so forth. So you have to make sure that you follow the ratings. And over here is 7 to 12, so that's actually the rating over there. Next is installation. Now, the instructions are clear. This whole slides are already on Moodle. You can actually download it and you can follow the instruction, or you can just Google it. Now, these instructions are for Windows 10 and Windows 8. If you have a different system, let's say Apple or iOS or Linux, you'll have to Google the instructions yourself. Okay, so let's say you did all of that. You connected the computer and you installed the IDE and then you saw it. Now the IDE actually looks like, what is it, like this. Actually, I can open it from here and show you. So here's the IDE. This tiny thing right here is the IDE for Arduino. As soon as you start IDE, you will see that it's already pre-filled with two programs, setup and loop. And essentially, in the setup, we will do the setup code, and I will discuss what that means later. And the loop is the function that you want the system to do. Now, before you start writing any code, before you even come to here, these buttons right here are actually important. So verify here, it only checks the program. It basically sees if there is any errors going on. This one right here is upload, equivalent to compile and run. It uploads to the Arduino. Remember when you said before that there has to be a linkage between, where is that slide? Here. You'll have to basically write a program and then it will have to send it to the board. So this is basically the upload part. When you actually write the program and you hit on upload, it will actually go through here and then send it to the board. Maybe I should have put this guy here and then this guy over there, so the arrows will be, anyway. So that's basically the first step. Now, where are we? Yeah, we're back here. So then here opens, this basically is open file. If you created a sketch and then you saved it somewhere and you want to open it again, here it is. This one right here is for a serial monitor. This is one of the ways we're going to use to display the output. Think of it like a command prompt. And finally, there's more additional information. You can actually click on search, which is right here, and then you can actually see more details. But most of the time, we will use only those guys right here. Okay, so let's get back. So going back to the actual Arduino, so you can see it right here. So here's the verify, upload, new file, and then open, and then save. So this saves the file. This is opens a new one. This is open, open an existing one. And this is a brand new one. So you click on this and you can actually open up a brand new instant altogether. What happened here? Yeah. So basically this. Now, before you actually start writing program, here's what you should have done first. First of all, you should ensure that you have built the hardware. Or maybe if you just want to test it. Maybe you don't have any hardware, just want you have the board only and you want to switch it on and see if we are connected. So bring the board connected to the power, switch on the power. Or if you're using the USB directly, so take the USB cable and plug it into any of the ports of the PC here. So that's what I meant by here. So after you've done with your hardware setup, connect the Arduino to the PC through any available USB port. In the Arduino IDE, click on Tools, Port, and select any of the available ports. What does that mean? Well, that means here. Go to Tools and click on Port. Right now, I don't have any Arduino connected, but if I did, then this will actually be able to open, and another menu will open up here, showing Port 1, Port 2, Port 3, or COM1, COM2, COM3, and then you can then select one of them. Which one? Just select one anyway, okay? Just select whichever you like. Once you do that, let's get back to the slide. Once you do that, the next step is to check. How do you know whether this COM was the correct one or not? You'll have to do what is called get board info. That means after you have done here and you selected it, you click on grid board info. Now, if you have connected it correctly, you're going to get a pop-up that says board has been connected, or this is the information you ask for. But if you get an error like this guy right here, it says select a port because I haven't selected any port. Then it will give you an error right here. It says that we don't know what you're talking about. So if that happens, you have to come back here, go to port, and then select another one until it works for you. So once this is done, then we're good to go. And then you can then write the program. And then once you write the program, I'll get back to those in a minute. Or in our next video when we do the tutorials. And then essentially, these are the commands, serial print, special commands that shows the output. This is delay, if statements, etc. And then this is what happens if we have libraries, of course, if we have to use sensors. And essentially, this is the Arduino basics. And the last thing I'm going to show or talk about before we move on to the tutorials is the breadboard. Now, the breadboard essentially is where we're going to connect all the components together. Now, before we talk about the breadboard, you just need to pay attention to how this breadboard works. Essentially, we're going to use these holes here to insert the wires, so therefore we don't have to use soldering. Now, these holes right here are actually connected. How are they connected? These are horizontally connected, meaning this and this and this and this and this are all connected. In fact, all of them until the end of the line. And right here are also connected, but this one and this one, they are not connected. So these are horizontally connected. These are negative and these are positives. And the same thing down here, this is positive and this is negative, and they are also horizontally connected. But here on the other hand, these are actually vertically connected. Meaning that this one and this one and this one and this one and this one are all connected, but these are not connected. So vertical line, vertical line, vertical line, and so on are all connected. Similarly, this line and this line are not connected. So this guy and this guy are actually not connected. So this line and this line are also separate from each other. So with that in mind, I know there's a lot of theory here that doesn't make sense 100%. So hopefully with the tutorials, it will make sense. So I'll see you in the next video when we talk about the tutorials, and we're going to do the first two tutorials together. All right, so I'll see you in a bit.